Hello and welcome to Games You Might Be Missing. Every day I go on Steam and see what's coming out, what will come out in the future, and I make it into a list that I show you right here of games I think you might be interested in. So without any further ado, let's get started. California Games is a game from 1988, and I hope it looks that way and not being deceptive. I played this game on a very old, I think it was even a 286 at the time, and I remember loving it. I really have no idea how it plays now, but it was a lot of fun for me and my brothers when we were young, and it has lots of mini-games, and I remember it very fondly, so I thought I'd at least mention it. It's out now, it'll cost you $5, so if you're into old retro games, this could be for you. Falcon Age is a new game, it's gonna come out very soon. It's about you and a tiny falcon, and the falcon is super cute, and you go around having adventures. I read a few articles about its design, about its implementation. It looks very cool, very interesting. It's supposed to be played in VR, but it should work without it. So if you have a VR rig, I highly recommend it. And if you don't, you should probably still take a look at it. It comes out in about 3 days, no price point yet. Outriders is the new game from People Can Fly. If you don't know People Can Fly, they made the original Painkiller, they made Bulletstorm, which is an incredible game if you haven't played it yet, and this is their new game coming out in holiday 2020, which in these strange times means I don't know. Currently the price point is set to $60, and at this very moment we don't know a lot, except it's a 1-3 player co-op shooter in a new IP. It looks amazing, like it should. And the idea of a first-person shooter, which is not PvP, which is not Battle Royale, which is supposed to be working together to accomplish a common goal and have fun together, seems very appealing to me. And as you can see, even the in-game gameplay footage isn't really gameplay, so just gonna have to wait and see. But I recommend you follow and wishlist. The original Super Meat Boy wasn't really revolutionary at the time. I mean, we've had difficult platformers, but it gained a kind of a cult following. I still haven't played it, though I have it in my library. And this one is the required sequel. So if you like hard-as-nail platformers, if you like dying all the time, but with high quality of life features so you can keep playing and not feel tired, then play Super Meat Boy, and then play Super Meat Boy forever. Currently set to release in 2021, no price point. Fury of Dracula is one of my all-time favorite board games. I love it. It's a 1v4 cooperative competitive strategy board game in which four players play the hunters and one player plays the Dracula, and Dracula's purpose is to run around Europe and spawn vampires while the other hunters are trying to stop him. It's got some great mechanics. The third edition brought it all together, very well done. Now it's coming to digital, so hell yeah, I'm interested. It's a very good game with hidden mechanics and stuff like that, and it's much better if the game itself will prevent Dracula from cheating, which happens because it's difficult. As I said before, I love this game, I can't wait to play it again, especially now that we can't play in person anymore. As you can see, no release date yet and no price point. But as I did, I recommend you follow and wishlist. And as always, if you like my work, I have a YouTube channel that you're supposed to be on, I have a Twitch channel, I have a Facebook page, Twitter, all at SaberRunner, or in this case, SaberRunner Gaming. Thank you for following, thank you for watching, see you next time, stay good, have fun.